Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. What I have here today is a Google Home Mini, and what we're going to do is get this fully set up and ready for you to use in your home. So let's get going. Now, I've already opened up the Google Home Mini here. It's just this simple. Here's the box, and once you get that opened, you have a Google Home Mini itself. You can see this is the charcoal version. There is a power connector on the back, and there is also a mute mic switch here on the back. There's also some physical controls, which I'll show you in a bit. The second thing here that you get is a power adapter. It's a mini USB, and obviously that's going to connect into the back of the Google Home Mini. And the third thing you're getting is, just simply put, a manual of sorts. Now, we don't need this because you're watching this video here. So let's get going with the setup process. All right, now there are a couple of things you're going to need in your home before you can set up a Google Home Mini or a Google Home if you have one. So the first thing is Wi-Fi in your home. So obviously you need to be connected to the internet, and your Wi-Fi signal has to be broadcast such that this device can pick it up. The other thing you're going to need is a smartphone of some sort. Now, I have an iPhone, but ultimately you could have an iPhone or an Android device. Now, getting into this, I've already plugged in my power adapter actually below me, and we're just going to go ahead and connect in to the Google Home Mini. And what you're about to see is some lights start to light up here and a short process that it goes through. So you could see those lights starting to go, and when you get to four lights that are fully on and you get an audible sound here from the Google Home Mini, you're ready to set it up on the iPhone or Android Google Home application.
Welcome to Google Home. To get started, download the Google Home app on a phone or tablet.
So there you go. They're already telling you you're going to need the Google Home application. Now, as I said before, there's a couple of physical things that you can do on this device. So right here, that's the volume up on the speaker, and on this side, that's the volume down. So those are two buttons for control, and then there is this mic switch on the back.
The mic is muted.
So you can mute it.
The mic's back on.
And bring it back on just that easily. All right, now we're going to get into the setup process here. I'm going to go into the Google Home application, and there are a couple of things you're going to need there. So you will need a Google account. You can sign up in this application for a new Google account if you don't already have one, but I'm not going to do that today. Just suffice it to say that there should be a Google account up at the top left of this by the time you're done. What I will do is leave a link down below for where you can go and sign up for a Google account if you don't already have one. Again, it would just be a matter of putting in the credentials that you create through that Google account into the Google Home application as you go through the setup process for the very first time. Now, as I said, I have that in here. And so what's shown up is that a device is found and is ready to set up. So I'm going to tap that card, and it's starting the connection process already. You can actually see that the lights on the Google Home Mini have gone blue here, and that we're starting this connection process. So it's quickly asking me, did I hear the sound? Yes, I did, obviously. Do I want to help improve Google Home Mini? This is a pretty standard thing that companies now ask you, whether or not you want to help them improve by sending reports to them when there's issues. So I'm going to say no thanks, I don't want to do that. Now what you're doing is you're choosing where the device is. This can change over time. You're able to change the room that this device is set up in. And for now, I'm going to choose my living room. So I've chosen next, and now the next step in the process is to set up my Wi-Fi network. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to tap on the Wi-Fi network here, tap next, and it's asking for the Wi-Fi password. Now, clearly I'm not going to show you my Wi-Fi password, but I am going to type it in here. And once I've done that, I can also choose to use this Wi-Fi network in the future. So Google will save the credentials. Some people might like that, some people don't. So I'm going to hit done and connect, and you can see it's now changed from the blue lights back to white, and it's going through a connection process here on the Google Home. So now we have a connected device here, and your Google Home Mini is starting to show some different lights there. You can see it running through, and the Google Assistant, basically, they want to tell you some things. So there is some privacy discussion here on this page. You'll want to understand how guests can use this device in your home. So there are capabilities here that you'll have to be aware of. And then there's also partners where they share data. This is kind of a standard thing for really using anything Google related. So now that I've gone ahead and I've accepted or understood some of those things that Google was telling me about, I do have to go through a little bit more related to the Google Assistant itself. So you can see that there are a couple of settings here. Do I want to give some device information? So store information about my contacts, the calendars. That really works much better with an Android device than it does with an iPhone in terms of the calendars, but it does still work in terms of contacts here with an iPhone, so keep that in mind. There's music, other data in your device, and basically the voice and audio activity. So this is Google actually recording what you're doing with the Google Home Mini. They actually do record what you say on their servers. You could say no thanks at this point, and it would not store that information, but what it does is Google over time does learn your requests, your voice, what you do with the device, and it helps to give you better results over time. So for myself, I'm going to go ahead and turn that on. I don't mind that, and you can clear that. We have videos like that on the channel. Now here we are at the voice match portion of the setup. What this is doing is you're basically teaching your Google Home Mini how to use your voice. So you can see it's asking me to say, "Okay, Google. Okay, Google. Hey, Google. Hey, Google." So now it's just running through a voice match setup process. What it's actually doing is taking my voice from here and putting it on the Google Home Mini, kind of teaching the Google Assistant in the cloud as well what my voice sounds like when using those words. So now we have the ability to get personal results with my voice. So personal results gives you a lot of opportunity to things like your calendars, again, and your contacts, those kinds of things that are specific to you as a person. So I'm going to go ahead and turn that on as well. I would suggest for most people, go ahead and do that. Now, right out of the box, there are two voices that you can choose from. You can pick from the samples, but in the end, you will actually get a choice from 8 different voices when you're using the English language here. So I'm going to go ahead, tap next, and now I've got to enter in my address. This is for the maps and navigation portion of the Google Home Mini. Now we're on to something that I think a lot of people are going to care about. There is Google Play Music, YouTube Music, Spotify, and Deezer. These are all base services that you can use on the Google Home Mini. If you have any of these accounts, you can go ahead and sign in. Now you can see that Google Play Music has already been added, and that's associated with your Google account that you started with at the start of this process in the Google Home application. So if you have a Google Play Music subscription or now a YouTube Music subscription, which can also be YouTube Red in the US, if you have that, use that account to set up your Google Home Mini. Now, I'm not going to go ahead and add any other services here, but you would just simply click the plus there and go ahead and put in your credentials to that other music service. Now, if you also have Chromecast devices in your home, they're going to show up here if they're already set up. You can simply tap a check mark to set it up as a Cast device associated with this Google Home Mini. If you don't have those in your home, you can add them later. Don't worry about it, but we're just going to go ahead and tap next again. Google wants to know if you want to go ahead and sign up for any of their surveys. I'm going to go ahead and tap no thanks. And now we're almost done here, so we're kind of in a review portion. If I want to add a caller ID, so when you make phone calls with your Google Home Mini, which you can do, do you want to use your own number? I'll show you how to set that up. I'm going to add a phone number here, and you do have to choose your country. So I'm in Canada. I'm going to go ahead, tap on that, and then type in my phone number here. So I've gone ahead and done that, and I've tapped verify. Now, what Google always does is basically that second step of verification. Did I get a code? Yes, I did. Now I've gone ahead, typed that in, and right away, Google has verified my number. So that will be my caller ID now as I make phone calls on my Google Home Mini. So now I just go ahead and tap back. And again, if I'd like, I can link more music services. I can change all these other components to the setup if I'd like, or I can just simply hit next, and we're into installing an update now. So this will bring me up to the latest version, and this is the only time with a Google Home, a Google Home Mini, or a Google Home Max that you will have to sit and witness an installation of an update. So otherwise, what happens is your Google Home Mini will install updates in the background. You won't even know they've occurred in a lot of cases. And you can check on the device settings when those are installed if you'd like, or you can look at what's called the cast firmware version. Okay, so now the update has been installed, and they're going to go ahead and take me through.
Hi, I'm your Google Assistant. I'm here to help, to learn a few things you can do. Continue in the Google Home app.
All right, so we're all done the setup process. They're going to take me through a little bit of what you can do with your Google Home Mini. That's not the point of this, but what I can tell you right now is this Google Home Mini is ready to answer questions for you. It's ready to make phone calls. You can go ahead and get that started. You can obviously start music, and if you had a Chromecast in your home already, you can cast to that device or ask it to play content on that device. So you already have a great deal of capability. On the channel are all kinds of usage videos in terms of setting up home control, obviously making those phone calls, how to do that specifically, connecting to Bluetooth with a phone or a tablet or another device, using a lot of other devices and functionality that the Google Home Mini is capable of. So I'm going to leave it there, but thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time.